Yo, YouTube, what is up? Radar 25 back in with my co-host, Michael Fuentemania.
What up, Mox?
Guys, you know what time it is. We're live to tape in the studio, the Radar 25 studios. It's Monday Night Raw. We only have two takeaways from this show. It was a big, heavy Survivor Series team building episode. That's all that really much happened here. There's a lot of team building for the Survivor Series matchups, those traditional Survivor Series matchups that we've seen in previous years, Raw versus SmackDown. Haven't heard anything of NXT yet getting involved there, but I'm pretty sure they will get involved. We have the matches already set up, the singles matches, champions versus champions. We got exciting matches built up there. We have The Fiend setting his eyes on Randy Orton. We have Miz, Mr. Money in the Bank showing up there and already challenging having issues with Drew McIntyre from the start. We have Retribution, another disaster from Retribution. We got a lot to get into. We only have two takeaways, but they're two really big ones from the show. So let's get into it. Before we do, we take care of a little business. You know, in the description section below, you have the links for Amazon. Do your Amazon shopping through there. You hit that link, shop through there, kicks back towards the channel. You have the Honor Club. Sign up to the Honor Club for ROH. You have Fight TV app. Watch your wrestling, MMA, boxing, all through there. Use that link, kicks back towards the channel. Highspots.com, you have that. Wrestling merchandise, whatever you guys want to buy, t-shirts, signed memorabilia, toys, whatever's on that website, use the link in the description below, kicks back towards the channel. Obviously, you know, if you're watching this video, you're enjoying this video, you're liking the studio, you're liking the way we come out with these videos, remember to like this video, smash that like button, subscribe to the channel. If you're not subscribed already, hit the notification bell so you guys are alerted when new videos drop. Remember to follow the Instagram, the Twitter, the Twitch for the live streams. Your boy's TikTok is blowing up. Follow me on TikTok. It's the same handle as Twitter and Instagram. Boy is jumping to 1,000 followers on TikTok within a week and a half to 2 weeks. So let's get it up higher and higher. So the TikTok is blowing up. Make sure you follow me on there. But without
look at you, aren't you instant famous?
Big time stuff going on there. So without further ado, let's get into the video. Our two takeaways from Monday Night Raw. All right, guys. So Monday Night Raw started off with your former WWE champion, Drew McIntyre, hitting the ring, explaining what happened at Hell in the Cell. He was pretty chipper. Yeah, I mean, he just said he lost pretty much, but he's going to go back after Randy Orton. He gets interrupted by The Miz and John Morrison. Miz, your new Mr. Money in the Bank. They just taunt him the entire time. They taunt Drew McIntyre. Really disrespectful tone they took with Drew McIntyre this entire time. Drew McIntyre does not like it. He beats that ass. But mostly Morrison was taking all the hits for him, which I thought was kind of interesting. You saw that, right? Yeah, it was like all the bumps. Yeah,
he makes everything look really good. So probably just
Of course. Yeah.
Miz not the greatest worker. Let's make say Morrison flies all over the place. And that's what he did. He did his job.
Yeah, the way John Morrison's athleticism is and the parkour stuff, it really oversells the big huge tosses by Drew, like the way he's tossing him up
like
in the air. Yeah, exactly. Which is interesting because who he's gonna end up probably having to face sooner rather than later. Later on, so they would have this issue. They would brawl, and this would set up a match later on the night, Drew McIntyre versus The Miz. But that's pretty much how the show started off. Yes. After this, we had AJ Styles come out with his new bodyguard. The size difference of these two is just amazing. Like they do it on purpose. They do the camera angle where AJ stands directly in front of him. He's barely chest height on the guy behind him. I forget.
This guy's really big. What the hell's his name? Did he give his name yet?
I said it on 2 weeks ago. It was Jordan something. He has a very tough last name to pronounce, but it's like Jordan something. He has a name as of right now. He has a name on the show. Yeah. They don't really refer to him as his name on the show, but he's just there. So obviously,
He's like Great Khali big. Like he's a big boy.
And he looks a little bit more. He looks a lot more athletic than Khali does, too. Yeah.
Anybody does, really.
Yeah, a lot of people do. I think, most people's grandparents look more athletic than Khali sometimes.
Come on, are you serious?
Yeah. So he's going against Jeff Hardy, and this is for Survivor Series placement on the Survivor Series teams for the respective brands. So this whole show was built around Survivor Series. Let's get into it real quick. They announced all the matches for Survivor Series, the title versus title that we had previous years. We got Roman going against Randy Orton, champion versus champion.
Like mouth-watering clash. Yeah, it should
be. With a heel. Roman against Randy Orton should be interesting. Yeah. You have Bobby Lashley going up against Sami Zayn, which should be an interesting match in and of itself because we've seen that match a lot of times before back on Raw, going back like a year and a half ago. So we're going to get that. You have that going down there. You're going to have the tag team Survivor Series matchups going, which I never really liked. They're hit or miss. You got a lot of that. You're going to have Asuka going against Sasha, which we've seen a million times in recent history. So we got to see it again.
Over the summer, that was like the biggest feud in the women's division. So we'll see it again, baby. One more time.
We're going to see it again going forward in Survivor Series. So AJ Styles wins this matchup. He is part of the team now. Elias comes in and hits Jeff Hardy in the back with the guitar. So that feud will continue going on after that. Next thing on the show, we had Lucha House Party versus Drew Gulak and Akira Tozawa. This is a waste of time. You had R-Truth come in, and you know, even though the Lucha House Party was able to get the win, a lot of interference from R-Truth. He still has issues with Gulak with 24/7 Championship. It's a lot going on here. Nobody really cares. This is an absolute disaster.
Keep it moving.
Yeah, nobody wants to see this anymore.
We're losing subs because talking about this.
Elias versus Keith Lee. Keith Lee would come out and have this match against Elias. It's another qualifier for the Survivor Series team up. Keith Lee would get the win here from distraction. I hate these distractions that they do when it's just the music that plays, right? The music just plays. He looks up. Oh, shit. And then, boom, he gets hit, and it's over with him. So he loses this match. Keith Lee qualifies for the Survivor Series team along AJ Styles at this point. Then you would have Jeff Hardy hit Elias in the back with the guitar. Shot. So
one more time.
Tip for tat right there. Yeah. Yep. There's still issues between Braun Strowman and Keith Lee, so we'll probably see them have issues going forward. So excited to see that part. All right. So let's get to the first takeaway, first of two. Now it's gonna be the Hurt Business versus Retribution. Now, all right. So it's Hurt Business versus Retribution once again.
Retribution's back. Ready to do nothing.
Now this is interesting. This is an elimination matchup. So you know each member is eliminated. Pretty much a Survivor Series match. That's all it was. Yeah. So
preview.
It's the whole entire Retribution versus the whole entire Hurt Business Retribution on the side with a Reckoning Mia Yim on the outside. She would get involved in this match in like the worst way possible. But let's get to the first thing here. And it's the fact that Retribution started off as a rogue group that was destroying the company, right?
They're Molotov here to cocktails.
Yeah, they're here to destroy the company completely, and then they get signed.
Poison.
They get signed by Monday Night Raw. They're signed superstars. Now that was bad enough, right? Now they're Raw exclusive. Now from there on, they have their matches, and now they literally have their own entrance music, their own Titantron music. I mean, a video, and they come out from the back like a regular superstar.
Gold, that is exactly the opportunity.
I think that's the worst decision ever made. Akin to when Crow's Sting decided to come out. He came out at Starrcade 97 against Hogan. He came out from the back like a regular dude when he was the when he was the rogue guy who was fighting the NWO for WCW. So it hurt him in that aspect because it takes away some of the mystique. So with this team being a rogue team here to destroy him, they come out in the back. So that means they were hanging out in the back by, you know, Gorilla, and they come out and then, you know, they see everybody. They're not really destroying shit. So if you want to have a, you know, a sense of like suspending your disbelief at certain points, you should have just kept them with no music. The lights flicker. They come out from the crowd. That's it every single time. But they have the match. You have its elimination match. Then at one point in this match, you have Reckoning Mia Yim come up to the apron, and then she starts like twitching and scratching, and then she gets in the ring and starts like flopping all around the ring. She's
going on.
Whoa. She's having a fit.
What
the world is happening?
Supposedly, she said on her Twitter she was possessed. That's what she's doing. That's what her excuse was, because I think people came at her a little bit saying that it was like she was copying seizures and it wasn't right or something like that. But she said she was possessed. It was just a ploy to get MVP eliminated. He gets eliminated. At the end is Shelton and Cedric Alexander versus Mustafa Ali. Then Mustafa Ali will use a chair, get disqualified. That's the way the match ends. Terrible. Absolutely terrible. They lose again. Retribution continues to lose. It's a terrible thing. Let's get rid of Retribution already because it's a disaster.
I'm starting to think Retribution is not really Vince's idea.
Yeah,
someone just
I
threw it one day
at
him. I was like, we're going to do this. And then I was like, then it just kind of shaped itself into what we see today, where we got people having seizures or being possessed by God knows what.
Yeah.
There's one point, get off me, get it off me. I was like, did I miss something? Let me rewind. No, she just started doing that randomly. Okay, weird, very strange. Yeah, I think Vince just doesn't really care about it, and they're just kind of just make sure they lose every week and build her business up and make them stronger, I guess. I guess that's the whole point of them at this point. They're not, and they have a promo afterwards. It's just, it kind of feels like there was a point in like in the summer where the board you know, like the shareholders basically said, what's going on? Where's the new talent? Where's the fresh faces? And they came up with that crap and it just sucks. And it's like Raw Underground. Hopefully in a few weeks, it's just gone. And they just go away from it because it's not good. It's not good. What's the purpose? They're not a threat. They're not a liability to anything. They're not destroying anything. And I'm going to take it back a little bit because we're going to take Sting because that's Sting. It's a different, way different level than Retribution.
Of course.
I get your vibes of like you're supposed to be this dark, ominous thing that's not really following the rules of the system that are in place, and you're literally just doing the same thing. And you have merch, and you have whatever.
It was logos and stuff like that.
It's just like what's the purpose? And I don't know. It's hard to explain how bad they are. You just really gotta watch it and just feel it because it's missing on all aspects. It's missing on everything. They look stupid. Their mission statement is like complete. They do the opposite. Why are they even there? It's just pointless. It's completely pointless at this juncture in time. There's no hope. I can't see them like, oh my God, they're gonna start dumb. I don't know, unless some crazy stuff happens, but it's gotta be really crazy for them to start getting any type of really over with anything. So I don't know, just kind of cut your losses and get the hell out of there. Just pull the plug. Pull the fucking plug.
Yeah, pull the plug on all this. The whole reckoning Mia Yim thing was pointless. I mean, it was effective, I guess, because it got MVP eliminated, but it was pointless in the end. It was just
it was effective for the story, but people watching at home were like, this is really, really stupid.
Yeah, they were like, what the fuck is this thing? Yeah, it makes no sense.
What's the point of this? Like, and that's the best you can do with her? Like, she's been useless for like 3 weeks now, ever since they got rid of Mercedes Martinez, and she doesn't attack any of the women. Doesn't help the guys out when they're wrestling because they're wrestling giants. So it's like, you know, what are you supposed to do? Like her versus Bobby Lashley? Come on.
It
doesn't make any sense. It's just all so dumb.
It's terrible. And like the picture behind us before was the picture of Slapjack, and that's why I picked that picture to you know, kind of symbolize just from the start how bad this group has been. And Slapjack is the worst of them all just because of the mask they gave him. But yeah, them coming out from the back makes no sense. Takes away from everything they've done. And all they've done is they were supposed to shake things up and destroy the company or whatever, or seem to destroy the company. All he did was just give the Hurt Business a few victories here and there, and that's pretty much all they've done. So they lose again as disqualification. Guys, that's takeaway number one. Next thing on the show, we had the Miz Drew McIntyre matchup. It's not much here. You know, Miz controlled a little bit of the beginning of the match, but then Drew McIntyre started tossing him around. Morrison out on the outside, hit a Claymore kick. He gets the win. He celebrates in the ring, and you see Matthew McConaughey with his kids on the Thunderdome screens in the back. So whatever, cool little thing there. That is what it is. You know, we're
all right
now. Morrison just seems like the comedy sidekick to Miz. So we'll see what happens with that when they eventually, hopefully, break up. Now, next thing we had Adam Pearce, as per usual, making his obligatory, you know, obligated
once a show,
however many times a show, but he has to show up at least once on a show. He shows up here. He's gonna name the members of the tag teams, women's
Survivor Series.
Yeah, it's a Survivor Series team. Yeah. It's for the Raw Women's Survivor Series teams. Yeah. So the captains of the team are the tag team champions, Nia Jax, Shayna Baszler. They would add Mandy Rose and Dana Brooke. And then they would add the winner of the Fatal 4-Way. That would be Lana, Peyton Royce, Nikki Cross, Lacey Evans. First time seeing Nikki Cross on Raw, I believe, since she was drafted.
She was there last week?
Maybe she was. Who the hell knows? But yeah, at this point, you know, let us know in the comment section if we got that wrong, if she was there last week. I don't think she was, but whatever. So the match was what it was. Surprisingly enough, you have Lana getting the win, which is, it's just funny the way WWE does these things. So Lana gets the win. She's part of the Survivor Series team. She seems to, you know, she goes out to celebrate. Nia Jax gives her a hug, and then for the sixth time, she puts her through a table again with a Samoan drop. It's a running gag on the show. They keep putting through a table. So
it's never going to end. It's becoming the 24 championship. It's just like stupid.
Yeah. I'm not sure what they keep doing. I mean, like, I think Vince just finds it funny, or he's just taking it out. You know, they're burying her, but they're giving her shots, but then they're burying at the same time. So whatever. We'll see what happens. You know, we'll see what SmackDown looks like, because the Raw team's kind of weird. It's kind of odd team up. The women they have there, but it is what it is. Next thing on the show, we have Matt Riddle versus Sheamus. Matt Riddle, You know, he's on Raw now, so is Sheamus. Sheamus gets the win here, so Sheamus does qualify to be part of the Raw team. He goes with AJ Styles now and Keith Lee. So we'll get more. The final, you know, the final two members will be shown at a later date.
Formidable team right now. Formidable team so far.
I'm kind of upset to see Matt Riddle like take a L here. I kind of feel like they would have built him a little bit better. But let's see what happens with him. Sheamus gets the win. Matt Riddle hopefully continues and maybe gets a little bit better. Now let's get to takeaway number two. This is the end of the show, but we'll preface it with the Firefly Funhouse. You can obviously see that playing in the background behind my head right now, one of the monitors. But yeah, the Firefly Funhouse was probably the most wild one of them all. And it was the most wild one of them all. One of the most wild one. They were dressed up to seem to be like a Alice in Wonderland, Wonderland
Mad
look.
Mad Hatter.
Yeah. So, they had like a little possession here because you have Bray Wyatt with he looks like he has new contacts with like sky blue eyes now.
Yeah, he
would put his hand over Alexa Bliss and then her eyes would change into like some demonic looking eyes and she would just say let him in, basically saying that letting him in kind of transforms you like that, the Fiend. So it was interesting. She would hype up how excited she was for the moment of bliss with Randy Orton, and it would cut to Bray Wyatt because remember Bray Wyatt doesn't forget what Randy Orton did to him, and he would be standing there with a picture behind him of a fire, and he would have a serious face.
On a moment of bliss, I get to have a fun chat with the new WWE champion, Randy Orton.
So now we remember Randy and Wyatt's feud from a few years back would end up with, the House of Horrors match, and then Randy burning down the Wyatt compound house or whatever it was, basically killing Sister Abigail in the process, and give us one of the greatest photos in the history of professional wrestling. The one right behind us right now is one of the greatest photos in the history of professional wrestling. One of the most epic photos of him doing the Randy Orton pose.
Worst match ever, but definitely.
He was doing the Randy Orton pose with the fire in front of him. So they would do this spot. They would end up killing Rambling Rabbit again, bludgeoned to death by Bray Wyatt here, and then that would be the end of the Firefly Funhouse. Moment of Bliss would come on, and it would be a pretty interesting moment of bliss here because she's dressed, Alexa Bliss dressed kind of like a Chucky look to her, but she's giggling, smiling the entire time, real maniacal look to her,
creepy
look. She talks to Randy about the matchup that he had against Drew McIntyre. Drew McIntyre interrupts. Then, funny thing, they start brawling, and then Alexa Bliss just sits on the top turnbuckle laughing the entire time. The lights would eventually cut out, and they would come back on red. They would have Drew McIntyre in the ring by himself, Randy backpedaling, and none other than The Fiend will be standing right behind him. We'll be standing right behind him, basically saying he's coming for that title. And then it brings back the feud that they previously had when he was, a member of the Wyatt family. So The Fiend has his eyes set on the title. And it's interesting with Drew McIntyre being there. Well, we see Drew McIntyre versus The Fiend to see who faces Randy Orton. But like Randy Orton has a match for Survivor Series. He's facing the Universal Champion in Roman Reigns. But I thought it was an overall good segment. I continue to enjoy Fiend and Alexa Bliss and how that dynamic is working out.
Yeah, I love it too. I think throwing Alexa Bliss in there is freshening up that whole character, the whole Firefly Funhouse, having a new toy to play with in her. And she's doing a great job of playing the crazy, freaky Harley Quinn psycho girl. Love it. She's creeping me out. And then we got the whole, is it Randy versus Drew McIntyre, or is the Fiend's kind of lurking in the background, but it's Roman versus Randy at Survivor Series. So there's a lot of stuff going on with in the title picture. I'm not sure what they're going to do, if they're going to do a triple threat match afterwards or whatever after Survivor Series, or just kind of The Fiend just lurking in the background and kind of ruining both of these guys' lives over the next month or so until there's a match or the rematch or whatever the case may be. I'm excited to see where this goes, but definitely a fun segment. I'm enjoying all the characters involved. They're all doing a great job. It's exciting to see a fresh matchup with Drew and The Fiend and Randy and The Fiend, and it's all coming at like that continuity of a few years ago and bringing that storyline back. I'm digging it. I'm digging it a lot. So it was definitely a fun way to end Raw. I mean, it was a Raw and not a lot going on, just kind of this Raw was just emphasizing Survivor Series. It's in 3 weeks or whatever, and they didn't waste any time. They just were like, we're gonna make the teams and we're gonna get this thing going, and it's all about Survivor Series. So that's basically what it was, but this was a great ending to it, and I'm excited to see Drew, The Fiend, Randy, Alexa Bliss. I mean, so many toys to play with. I can't wait.
Yeah, there's a lot going on here and a lot they could play with going forward from here. But guys, that's takeaway number two. And that's the end of the show. Like you said, a halfway decent episode of Monday Night Raw. There's a lot of build up for Survivor Series. We got all the matches out. You know, the teams will still be assembled. Both sides. We'll see if they have the tag team Survivor Series matchups as well. With the Raw tag teams going against SmackDown tag teams, which they do most of the time.
They announced it.
They announced it, right? They announced that was going to happen.
They announced it.
So we'll have that, and then we'll see.
Even though the Herb Race is coming for those Raw tag team titles.
That is true. They're coming for those titles. Yeah, so we'll see what happens with the SmackDown men's team and then the SmackDown women's team as well on Friday. See how those get fleshed out. But guys, that's our videos. There's two takeaways from Monday Night Raw. An interesting Monday Night Raw with a lot of Fiend and Alexa Bliss in there. So we're enjoying all that. But without further ado, guys, that's the end of the video. Remember, if it doesn't work for you, do not do the job.
Later, Marks.